Our routes definition contains two types of logic. We define middleware, these callbacks, and we have the routes themselves. The first part, middleware, can be extracted to controllers, because actually they are controllers. They handle the request and return a response. So let's start with controllers. First of all, we define a root namespace for our application. Create a folder src and update composer.json file to add autoloading section. We are going to use PSR for autoloading and namespace up. This namespace will be mapped to our folder. To apply these changes, we need to update the autoloader by executing command composer dump autoload. Great, now we can put different parts of our application into different files. No more messy code. We start with products. Create a new folder products and a folder controller inside. Here we are going to put our controllers, this middleware. We start with a get request. Copy this and create a new file get all products. It will be a middleware with a magic method invoke, which accepts a server request. Paste the code, done. Now, the same way, we can create a new controller. Copy the middleware code, create a new class createProduct, add method invoke and paste the code. We are done with controllers. Let's check that they work as expected. Replace these closures with instances of controllers. For get request we use new get all products. And for post request we use new create product. Clean up the code and import namespaces. Ok, let's see. Start the server. The server is listening. Now send a get request to slash products. It works. And a post request. It also works, so the refactoring to controllers was pretty successful. But we still use a closure to define the routes. It means that if we need to pass an object here, it should be injected with use. And let's say we are going to inject products, orders, users. You see that this code starts looking a bit ugly. So we can go OOP and create our own router, instead of using this function. This router will be responsible for dispatching a route and calling a corresponding controller. In the root of the project, create a new class router. It will be a middleware, add method invoke, and copy the routing logic from the server definition. Oops, my mistake here. Of course, this exception throwing should be placed after the switch statement. So, we need a dispatcher here. It will be stored as a property. Add a constructor. The constructor will accept an instance of router collector. Inside the constructor, we instantiate a dispatcher. Create an instance of group count dispatcher. And provide data from router collector. What does this class mean? Router collector, we use it here inside the closure to define routes. Now click on the function. This is what happens under the hood. Here is the dispatcher and it accepts data from the router collector. And this is how we create an instance of the router collector. It requires a router parser and a data generator. So we can repeat this code. Routes equals new router collector. For route parser we use std and for data generator we use group count based. import namespaces, and remove a closure. Here are our routes. The last step is to replace a closure here with an instance of the router, which accepts our routes. Done. And again, let's check that everything still works. Restart the server. Send a GET request. Then POST. Yes, everything works. And now we can start using that router to register new endpoints.